All right, welcome to Smokey Reacts. I'm your boy Journalist, and on this one, we are here to wrap up the Knuckle documentary. It has been broken into three parts. Two and three will be dropping on the same day, and this is part three. Thank you guys very much for rocking with me with this one. I had actually lost or misplaced the hard drive where part two was on, so I had to actually figure out whether or not I actually recorded it so I could see if I had to do part two over and whether or not I needed to actually do that all the way from the start or this. So now I found it. We're doing part three, so we wrap this up. Thank you very much for joining me and waiting on this one. If you could, please hit that like and subscribe for me. We are trying to actively grow the channel. Any other documentaries you would like me to view or watch or be a part of, please put them in the comment section, and I'll get to them as soon as I can. That being said, there's a Patreon in the description box, and let's get into this one and wrap this up. Let's go.
This has to stop now, sis.
It's all right, yes.
Right?
It has to stop.
What do you mean, keep it going? Mom, whatever ground you've picked, he says, don't worry about it, he says, fine ground, he says, that'll suit your way, he says. Just tell me, he says, we're 100% behind
him. It didn't matter what the women said. The fighting went on, and I kept filming. Most of the men didn't go in for fair fighting, but each family had their fighters. Michael was 25 now with children of his own. He was ready to take on his family's enemies.
Here's your head. Did I mean my
leg? My leg. Nothing really about more many people ourselves, but they've got nobody, so there's nothing special about them. Nothing special about you. At all.
I'm just still so disappointed in that boy for biting somebody.
The young man who challenged Michael was called David Joyce. I didn't realize it at the time, but this fight in a church car park went right to the heart of the feud. David was the son of Brian Joyce, the man who had been killed in London by Michael's brother, Curly Petty, 12 years before in 1992.
Uh-oh, caught him. Ooh, there we go. See, you ain't got to bite this boy. Ooh, we put him on a dumper trip. Gave him that 2 pieces of a biscuit.
Hey, Mike.
Good shit. Got your shit back.
It was David's father who had been killed, but what surprised me was that all the anger in the fight had come from Michael. Michael was always going to defend his family name, no matter what had happened in the past. After the fights, the families watched the tapes back at the site. It wasn't just winning that was important to them, but being seen to win. James always told me he'd only fought when he had to, and that he wished it would all stop. But the feuding had been going on for generations, and each fight just seemed to lead to another.
You see now, Barry, you're number one you're supposed to be. You're supposed to be number one.
Elevator, now, goodbye.
Joe.
Messy. You're not here, here, no peace. No peace. I'm good for nothing, both of you. I'm beating you, boy. I'm not fit, but I'm beating you.
I'm supposed to fight in match. And he wouldn't howl in match. He wouldn't howl in match.
James was true to his word. He hadn't fought again, but he was now refereeing for other traveller families. Big Joe Joyce was coming out of retirement to fight against one of his other enemies, Annie McGinley.
That boy got beef.
No shouting, no sight.
Oh, he's throwing them thumpers. Bumpers. What's up, cat? What's up? Weave it. Oh, he caught that uppercut. He's going to uppercut his ass. Something
I've
vicious.
I've been recording these fights for 9 years, and here I was in the middle of a forest filming two grandfathers beating each other up. Bits of my footage had ended up on YouTube, but I didn't really care about that. Something about this fight made me want to quit. I was there because I was getting a thrill out of it. It wasn't really about making a film anymore.
You got too close to the content.
I decided to stop. No more fair fights. I kept the tape to myself and didn't show it to anyone.
Ooh, thumped his ass. Hey, and that Joyce, oh, you cheeky cunt. These niggas be biting. He was winning. What did he bite him for?
You won your fight, up here.
Who won the fight? Who won the fight?
McGinley won that fight.
All the Tidigan,
he's qualified. He's qualified.
What did he do, Jim?
He bit his ear, he's qualified.
Thank you, Jim. Thank you.
He's beating that boy ass and then beat his ear for what reason?
Still king, still king, boy. Still king.
Where are you off to now?
Where are you going?
We're going home now to the pub, the boozer.
Okay, keep your mobile on, I'll give you a ring in a bit.
In the prize room in Kula.
Huh?
Martin's Lounge.
Okay.
See you later on, Ian. See you later, kid.
I'm a rolling stone.
Rolling stone, oh, oh, oh.
For a life of sin, I have paid the call.
I have paid that toll.
When I pass by, all the people say,
what did the people say, my boy?
Just another guy on the lost highway.
Lost highway, goddamn it.
I really believe that nothing can make me go back. Then Michael called. He said he challenged Big Paul Joyce to a rematch, and he wanted me to go to England to film it. He wanted revenge for the fight he'd lost 9 years before.
Damn, you coming back 9 years later?
I said I'd do it one last time.
Hey, side note, Carlsberg, your beer is fucking terrible. Oh my God, I'd rather drink a Tennent's than a Carlsberg. Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ. I'd rather drink a Tennent's than an innocent gun as well. Like, oh my God. Fuck. And I'd rather drink any liquor over beer. Fucking, I don't know how you folks drink so much beer. Boy's got goddamn husky blood. It's a life. It's a new baby.
Lots of shit for one choice.
That's terrible, but it's hilarious.
He's a week old.
Today.
He's a week old today, Jack, isn't he? Tomorrow, actually. Sorry. He's a week old tomorrow.
This man got a fucking portrait of Che Guevara on his fucking body. Oh, man.
Hey, buddy.
Them motherfuckers got the same haircut.
He's smiling.
Yeah.
James had abandoned his house and moved to the other side of town. He said he wanted to make a fresh start. Water was coming through the roof of his old place, but Michael was using the kitchen to train in.
How are you feeling anyway at the moment?
I'm feeling grand. I'm feeling very fit. Very fit, aren't you? I'm jogging every morning. Like, just not jogging this morning because my foot was training there yesterday. And sparring away, pads, jogging. Very fit. The man would say, I'll take it. I will. I'm feeling very confident now. Swimming mother's life. I'm feeling very, 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 very confident altogether. They should beat this fella within 40 minutes.
That's a long time.
No problem.
Why does this cunt have a fucking Confederate flag that says redneck woman? What in the fuck? How that flag has any relevance in reverse back to this country? Or England or Ireland. I don't give a fuck where these people are. That shit makes no sense. People just love hatred. That's crazy, blood.
We're
putting a pause on that boy. We're putting a pause on that boy. I was ready for that.
As you know yourself, you were there. You were there. That's almost 9 years ago now. You were there yourself.
Watch out.
Different story.
Bit his nipple.
Different kettle of fish. Different kettle of fish altogether. I was a different person. I was drinking, smoking, caught on the hop, as you know about this tape that he made.
What does caught on the hop mean? I don't fucking know.
A couple of weeks beforehand, so basically I was provoked into fighting.
Why are you holding the mitt so high? Oh, because old boy's taller than him, that's why.
This time now, I'd 4 months of training. I've been training before this. Before I've seen for him for a fight. Yeah. Different story. Basically, anyway, he won't be catching me to wrestle with me. He won't be catching me to wrestle with me.
Don't bite him. Beat this time. Nigga up with no bites.
Not this time.
Get your self-respect back. Oh, form is terrible. That's a lighthouse, y'all.
Come on, look.
You know, that's what this fight would be over today. This on Sunday, actually. That's what this fight is over. Over that tape that they made. Over this they made a tape almost 9 years ago. So that's what this fight is basically over. Because we had no argument with those people. Those are cousins of our own. We had no arguments with those people whatsoever. Until those people took up for their name.
Big Joe wants to get in the fight. He's not going to fight anyway. I wouldn't allow him to fight.
Not allowing him at all.
He shouldn't have no business going to fight.
No.
Would it not be possible for you guys to get together, talk about it, make up?
You crazy.
Why not?
He's like, somebody got to get their ass beat, huh? Somebody's getting
the
part.
A godfather. I'll sit down with him. Sort this all out. I would. Sit down with him, all right. Nah, there'll never be something of it. Not for as long as the Quinn McDonald's alive.
See the video of that song, lads? Yeah. What can we make
Shout out to Luton.
Just spoke to the referees, and the referees will be here at 9 o'clock in the morning to check and count this.
Them boys got, like, they about to go buy some drugs kind of money.
No, Michael, jeez, we left this in your hands, responsibility, right? Yeah. You can guarantee me the 60,000 sterling down.
60,000 down.
Have you another number in your pocket?
Yeah.
A short 1,000 then?
Yeah, I have this one here now. 60,000 sterling.
Boys got the bread.
Who you're fighting for? You're Quinn McDonough, right? You're Quinn McDonough. I want you to go out and fight him and take the head off his body.
I will.
Hit the heavy punches, put him on his arse, Michael, and keep him on his arse.
Don't run away with him, but you don't touch whoever. You know what you have to do, right? You know what you've been learning. You know the strength you have. You know everything that has been going on with your body. You know what we've been training about, right? You know the story. Go on,
go beat that job, right? Brother up.
Good luck, Michael.
Mexican, you've to count out 33,000 there, like Paul, haven't you? And the police, the crowd is showing up on the side, and the bigger the crowd gets, the more police are going to be around.
It was the hottest day of the summer, and the fight was going to take place on a traveller site in Hemel Hempstead near London.
Come in here.
This was the biggest ever bet on a traveller bare-knuckle fight. Each family were putting up £60,000, making a total of £120,000.
Where's Paddy Neal?
Boy, we about to get paid. What happens to the fighter that loses the 60K, though? Like, we just take that on the chin?
Michael, I want you to do me a favor when you're boxing that man, right? Tear his shirt off him. All right, tear his shirt off him. Let's begin. And what I want you to do is don't lose the head. Rodney Collins, I'm going to tell you, don't lose the head. He knows you're ready. He knows you're going to win this fight. He reckons you can't lose it if you do what you're told in the ring. What we learned, what you learned, you will not lose the fight, okay? Now, just tear his shirt off him. It'll make him look a bit embarrassing, right? Don't lose the head, Michael. You're not there to entertain people. You're there to win a fight. Good luck, Michael. Good luck. God bless you.
Good luck, Michael.
We're behind you. We're Quinns. Good luck. He's there drinking a cup of tea in the trailer. Hi. Laughing down the phone at me, drinking a cup of tea.
He knows, but he knows that I ain't.
That's a sign.
He's laughing down the phone. He better beat that boy up, because he bit that boy nipple. Man, spraying motherfucking I don't know what on his body.
Charlie, come here, Charlie.
Oh, they built the real ring and shit.
Michael,
you win the fight, the best of luck to you.
Yes, very much.
I've got the money. I'll come in straight away with the money and I'll give it to you.
That's
my hand on it.
That's good enough.
The money's not in this fight. I wouldn't have the money in this fight. This don't be too much here and I can have the money.
Okay, right. That's good enough.
Damn, ain't it? That motherfucker turned into a beast. That boy big as shit. He surely didn't stop
him. The best look to both you men, yeah? A fair fight. Yeah. No headbutting, no kicking, no nothing. Yeah.
Best look here. Oh, pull back the ring. Everybody
pull back.
Pull back the
ring.
Everybody keep the mouth closed. All back here. Yeah.
He could win this.
The fight's on. Stay on the phone, Bernie.
He just has to, what's the call? He has to
tell me, Bernie,
make a boy
me,
lose his energy quicker and then get past his fucking reach, because his reach is really what got him the last time. He just didn't know how to deal with it. Ooh, pressure. Nah, don't bite, don't bite. Ooh, good block. Ooh. You got a combo in, cuz. You got a combo in. Ooh. If this goes past an hour, he could win. Just off of old boy getting tired. He should start slapping the shit out of him, treating him like a little bitch.
We all can do that. Come on, be fair.
Be fair. Be fair.
Be fair. Be fair. Be
fair.
Come on, Michael Quinn. Come on, kid. Come on, old Davey Quinn and old Mikey Quinn, send them the power. The grandfathers in heaven, send Michael the power this time. Come on, Mick.
There we go. Put your ass up, Black. We got more to do.
Back up.
Two pieces of the biscuit, get in the family bucket. Let me go.
What lasts much longer, you reckon? One way or the other.
I reckon one way or the other won't last much longer.
There we go.
Yes, and you sent for me out of the blue.
Yes, but I tell you why. You sent for me out of the blue.
No, when did I send you out of the blue?
It's here. What do you
Stop. 1 second. I see that videotape now. I sent for you, but what did you send the tape? You'll find any juice in England around. Did you say that? Did you? No, but did you say that? But that's why I sent for you.
Why the tape? You made a tape. I knew you'd come up and you made
it. You can't forget about things like that. You sat down for 3 hours, man.
Start it out now, boy.
A draw, Maggie. A draw.
Hello?
He said Drody.
So I could solve a lot now, you know?
You really could.
Solve a lot.
Come on. You ended it like men. You did it like men. Let's get the fuck on. Nobody lost nay dollar. Look at them boys. Yeah, watch that blood off your face, boy.
Don't blow your nose.
You ain't beat him, but show the time.
Yeah. No fancy. Hold on. Get a powder for that.
Little crack anywhere.
That's fair. Who snitched, cuz? Got the whirly bird in the air.
There are scissors in there.
Man, we're straight for the cigarette and the drink.
Well, as Mama said, it was all about that bit of fair play. That's what it's all about.
Stop, but as long as there's no one else hurt or killed out of it, you know, just let them fight and get it out of the way. But I totally at the moment disagree with all the bare-knuckle fighting. It's got me nowhere in life, in that way. It's just got me in a way, it got me a name that I didn't want to have, because I would rather be not known for the boxing than being, I'd rather be known for something better, something more positive. Michael came home to us healthy, came home with his money. The Joyces went home with their money and lads were healthy. And I'd say it was 2 months later, everyone was talking again. That's how it is. You know, that's how it is. Now I've been invited to a wedding in Oxford next month. You know, and I think I'm taking up the invitation. There's a young Joyce fella getting married to a Joyce girl getting married to Gaffey in Dundalk. And I've been invited, so I think I'm gonna go over. That's how things are at the moment. You know, some of my people mightn't be too happy with me going over to Oxford. But I live for myself and my family.
That's right.
I'm my own person and I'll make my own decisions.
Big
of who I speak to and who I don't speak to. And, you know, it's like building bridges for me. It just goes to show you, from going back 10 years ago when the tapes were going around, how evil and how bad things were towards today.
I got a feeling.
That's it. All done.
The latest DVDs have just arrived in Curly Patty's trailer. The Quinn McDonoughs are at peace for now, but Big Joe Joyce is challenging the Nevins again. The feuding goes on.
Classic shit.
I'm fed 20 years of age. I'll be there, Parham boy.
The best man wins, isn't it, Dave? The best man wins, kid. Do you want to take a walk?
All alone and lost through a life of sin. I've paid the cost. When I go down, all the people
hit the big people ass with them tanks. He didn't hit motherfuckers so much, he don't got no knuckles no more, guys.
On lost way, just a Jacob car.
All right. Overall, I'm always down for a good, like, scrap. Like, seeing some motherfuckers fight, that shit is hilarious to me. But this just seems like it's just got a vicious cycle to it. And it just started from the stupid place, honestly. Like, rest in peace to what is it, Brian, I believe is the man's name that passed away. Yeah, rest in peace to the old boy. But just, like, I can just imagine now in today's time with cell phones and how kids are using them, just, like, it's probably gotten crazier. It's up again. But it'd be dope if, like, everybody settled their shit and nobody was fighting no more. But overall, Knuckle documentary, it was dope when I seen it the first time. It was dope to see it, like, as an adult and to, like, see where these people have gotten to. But, yeah, that'll be it for me on this one. If you could, please hit that like and subscribe. Patreon in the description box. There's other documentaries or anything else you want me to check out, please put it in the comment section. You guys are the reason why I started watching some of these things, so it'd be very helpful if you could do that for me. That being said, I'll see you guys on the next one. That's it for me. I'm out of here. Peace. You guys have a good evening.